Hello YouTube, this is Tiki Bomber here, and I'm doing this video this way because I've been watching a lot of PC versus console videos, mainly by Rags, and that's just because he's giving his side of the argument as to why the console fanboys tend to be wrong about PCs and the PC Master Race. And, you know, it's great to watch that and stuff, but every time I see him do these videos, which has been a lot lately, he's always talking about two consoles, the PlayStation and the Xbox. And that's fine. They could both be really great consoles. They could both be really horrible consoles. I really could care less because they're not the consoles I like to play. In fact, all the games for Xbox and PlayStation could be played on a PC. So, I really don't see a purpose in getting two other consoles for games that I could get on the PC, no problem. The other console he does not talk about very much, that I hear him talk, or even hear him talk or mention at all, and this goes for all console fanboys as well, is Nintendo consoles. Nintendo game systems like the Wii U, and the Switch. I never hear people talking about those consoles. And I do understand that the Nintendo Switch came out early to mid 2017, so that's still a brand new system itself. But it came out with indie games already to be downloaded. Something that console games in general hasn't been able to have for, I want to say, since the indie genre started to pick up steam. And I mean, Steam had indie games and indie genre available way before then. I mean, there's that Nikki Nightmare game that was made by RPG Maker. Yeah, that's an indie game. And I never saw it released for any consoles. I haven't seen any indie games really released for consoles. And I look at the Switch, and they have a huge lineup of indie games available. Furthermore on this, the Switch, unlike the PC, and unless you include a laptop, which, by the way, will never agree that a laptop is a PC gaming system. And there's a reason for that on a different topic. But no, the Nintendo Switch itself literally has a pick-up-and-go mechanic, which is a brilliant mechanic. It's something that they had put into it. And also how their controller, how sensitive the vibrations are in the controller to have you guess how many balls are in a box based off the vibrations. That's some hypersensitivity shit right there. Like some very realistic stuff. And I don't hear Rags really talk about the Nintendo console, and every time, and I do mean this, every time I go into a console war with one of my cousins, both my cousins with my brother, one will always take the PlayStation, one will always take the Xbox, and they flip-flop every year. My brother and I go and ask, well, what about Nintendo? And of course, like everything else, we get mocked at, lol, Nintendo's such a cheesy gimmick, lol, Nintendo's only for kids 10 and up. You know, like, the games Nintendo has is not really that noteworthy. When the Wii U was first launched, they didn't get their Nintendo-based games to launch with the Wii U. No, they had a zombie title launched with the Wii U. I can't remember the title of the game, but they had a zombie game launched with that, and that is pretty bad. And considering if you actually pay attention to the more dark lores that Nintendo puts into their games, they're not kid-friendly. Let's face it, Majora's Mask and Ocarina of Time were not kid-friendly. Those were some dark and deep, terrifying games. You want to go even further back, there's also Friday the 13th games that came out for the NES and the old other systems too. And that was a scary ass game because you have to run away from Jason Voorhees, who was pretty creepy in his own right. And don't tell me that Jason isn't a scary fictional character because he still gives kids and adults to this day nightmares, especially about camping trips. So, yeah, the Nintendo isn't just for kids. It is a great gaming system. They have great gaming systems set out, but unlike the PC, you can't really do backwards compatibility. They did have some backwards compatibility available for a while between the Wii and the GameCube games, but after that, no backwards compatibility at all was available. And that's just a sad thing in general. To know that you got this game system, these great game systems coming out, and nothing. You know, for the longest time, it was Nintendo and Sega that were the powerhouses of the gaming world, because they were the names that console families would actually have in their living room setup. I remember growing up with a Nintendo Entertainment System and a Sega in my house. Like, I was fucking spoiled. We got to play all sorts of games, like the Lion King game. We got to play the, there was a Mega Man game for the Sega Genesis. There was Fantasia. I had Animaniacs. There was Ren and Stimpy games. And then for Nintendo, we had, like, a lot of random different games, like Castlevania. There was this one game, I think, called Deja Vu. We had Friday the 13th. We had, like, a whole bunch of different games available. And, you know, Nintendo itself has been an icon in a lot of families' households. It is a strong company, still going strong. And let's face it, if I hear any console fanboys fapping about how great the Xbox is, remember, the Xbox One had an abysmal sell rate in Japan. I think on their launching week, they only sold a grand total of 5 Xboxes and ended up shipping back 500 million to the United States. That is sad. Really sad, actually, to the point where I'm like, well, shit, let's see how well the Switch does. And the Switch was everything expected and more. It's just like with my PC. I love to do everything with my PC, even though I really shouldn't, because I strain it by playing Skyrim. I love playing all my indie games on here. I love playing all my games that I have from Steam on here. I love playing my games that I can no longer find anywhere else on my computer. But there's only so much that my computer can do. You know, making videos, watching YouTube, social media, play videos, you know, play video games, and it's fun. It really is fun to play games on the PC. It is the master race. There's no denying that the PC is not the best system out there. And I was hoping that Nintendo would not go the same way that Sony and Xbox has done, where you're not only paying for, like, I don't know. I'm going to say my internet is the general base price of everyone's internet in the United States. You're paying about $125 per month on internet service. And then on top of that, you're paying an additional $15 a month for internet service for the Xbox. And if you have the PlayStation as well, that's another $15. So you're paying a grand total of $155 a month for internet service. And that's expensive as fuck. Why? Well, you know, they put that shit behind a paywall, and for a while, Nintendo didn't do that. Nintendo Wii and Wii U, while they still have internet access available, do not do that. There was talk that they would actually start doing that with the Nintendo Switch. And I'm really hoping that they don't do that, because that's just going to turn me away from the Nintendo systems itself, because they're going to start following these other two consoles' pathways. If you have $155 to dish out that a month, that's insane. That is insane right there. For $125, I pay for my internet, and then with that extra $30, I could go onto Steam right now and buy Fallout 4. You know, I can buy an additional game every month. I can buy a few games every month. And if the games are on sale and I'm looking for a new game to play or something new to try out, then guess what? I could actually get that game plus. I don't have to worry about spending $60 for a game that's going to be available with a physical copy, which is literally one of the few benefits about having a console is the physical copy of a video game. Like, literally, that and exclusives. And all systems across the field have exclusive games. And there's nothing wrong with the exclusive games themselves. I wish it weren't exclusive, but there is a point to make them exclusive. It is so that you will go out and spend about $400 for the newest gaming system available just to hook it up to your 4K TV and play at 30 frames per second with 1080 resolution. Yeah, not that great, is it? Or with a PC, like my PC, I have an old PC. I have a system that really cannot game that well. And the games I do have on it are old games. I have Skyrim, heavily modded. I have Ark. I have a huge list of games. Let's see, I told you Skyrim, Ark. I've got Brutal Legend, Elder Scrolls 3 and 4, as well as Magical Drop 5, Undertale. As you can see with me playing Undertale, I've got Borderlands 2. I have a whole bunch of these games. And the PC, for me, has always been the better gaming system in the long run because of the advancement of having MMORPGs. MMORPGs are the biggest thing for PC games and gamers. You go on, you'll probably see people playing games like Perfect World International, which has been out. Perfect World itself has been out and competing with World of Warcraft. And that is an old-ass game. But, you know, you have games like Perfect World International. You have games like Silk Road. You have games like Terra. Have a lot of games that are like for online, Astral Online, you know. You have all these different games that are just MMORPG based. And they're available for just the PC. And that is because the gaming mechanics are not readily available for the consoles. And there is a good chance that they will never be available for the consoles. So, I like consoles. They can get a little personal for me because I could play with my family and we can all have a good time. There are things that the console can do that the PC has been able to do for a long time. There is a few things the consoles cannot do that the PC will forever remain able to do for a time longer still. An example would be setting up your favorite new game that's coming out in the current year. But overall, I hear these debates about why PC is better than consoles, and I'm hearing the debate as to why consoles are better than PCs, and they're both great. You know, in all these arguments, I never really hear people talk about the Nintendo systems, because when you hear consoles, I'm hearing PlayStation 4s and Xbox One boys. And for the main of them, you know, I go and talk to these guys. Hey, I'm a gamer. And they're surprised. So they ask me what games I play, and I give them a whole list of indie games that I play. Like Portal and Portal 2. Well, those aren't technically indie games, but you know the idea. It was a whole list of games that I play. And a lot of them are multiplayer, a lot of them are single player. But when I hear them ask I ask them what games they play, and this is the answer I normally hear. Call of Duty and Madden. Call of Duty and NBA. Call of Duty and insert another sports title here. And I cannot. as much as people would love to say how great it is and how great of a game revolution it was for the entire gaming platform, Call of Duty had lost its luster right after the zombie Nazis DLC. After that, it was a copycat. It was literally a copycat carbon of it, copy of itself. Literally, cut, copy, paste. Cut, copy, paste. Cut, copy, paste. And there's nothing, and I do mean this, nothing good out of that. They're losing their sales. They're losing their friends. And the diehards who would sit there and be thumbs downing my video because I'm bashing on Call of Duty, I'm also bashing on the sports genre of video games itself. Because my thing, and this is just my opinion, not every single gamer's opinions, not every single PC gamer's opinions, this is just my opinion. If you want to play a sports game, gather your friends off of the couch and go play a sports game outside in your backyard, on the front lawn, at a park, at your friend's house, in the street, wherever. You don't have to sit there and play a sports game with your friends. Just gather your friends and go outside and play. Because that's... I understand people like to do that. Do not get me wrong. I don't understand why they like to do that. You know, it's like, why do people have to insist that consoles are better than PCs? Or why do people have to insist that PCs are better than consoles when both of them are really good? Overall, we're gamers. We shouldn't really be dividing ourselves. And I do hear Rags say this a lot. We should be more inclusive with everyone. And I do agree. But when it comes to things like playing a sports game on your couch, that's literally having a beer dispenser right next to you to actually dispense beer to you. So I'm at a loss of the laziness, I guess, is what I'm looking at here. Because sports are a game themselves. I don't really think they should have been made into video games, to be honest. Yeah, they do happen to hold some of the more older games out there. So does Oregon Trail, Old Oregon Trail, as well as a lot of the, what was that? Learn and play games? I remember playing those in elementary school. Shit. Old ass games on floppy disks and everything. As I give away my age. So, yes, sports games to me are not a game. And Call of Duty is literally refueling, recycling the same garbage over and over and over again. There's nothing new to it. Nothing. And then I hear people sit there and say, well, Battlefield's like that too. No! Battlefield is not like that. Battlefield actually has about 4 games out right now. They may end up getting a 5th one out soon. They don't release a game every 10 months just because they have to upgrade their graphics by like 2 niches and then re-release it as a whole new game. That makes no sense to me. And that's why I don't see Call of Duty players, especially the hardcore fanners, and sports game players, especially the hardcore fanners, as gamers. Just like I don't see a reason for this war between the PC game systems and the console gaming systems having to exist. Just like I don't see the exclusion of Nintendo gaming systems from being categorized in the console systems. As I said, every time, and I do mean this, every time I hear or see people talk about console systems, they always want to exclude Nintendo because it's Nintendo. And that literally makes no sense to me. You know, it's like if you were at a party, all your friends are talking about this new show that you've never heard of before. And all your friends are talking about this other new show that you've heard, but I'm going to say that you heard bits and pieces about them. But you are talking about a show that's been around for a long time and neither side wants to engage a conversation with you because they don't want to hear the quote-unquote same rhetoric of that show. I mean, it makes no sense to me at all. And I do really wish gamers in general could just get along, stop competing with each other, stop trying to bicker about who's got the bigger, better, harder running systems, because in the end, it doesn't matter if it runs the games or not if your system is broken. It doesn't matter if your games can be running or not if you don't have anyone to share them with or anyone to play them with, play the games with. All you're stuck with in that sad, pitiful existence is just you and a bunch of lonely-ass hours. And I would know something about lonely-ass hours, as I have over 2,000 hours clocked into ARK right now. So don't sit there and say that I don't know anything about video games, because I do know my fair share of video games. RTS are my favorite video games to run next to RPGs. And I do love MOBAs, especially Smite. Smite is like one of the best games that I've ever got to enjoy. While as other MOBAs like League of Legends, I wasn't able to fully enjoy because as soon as I jumped in and was asking people for help, I get called out on being a noob. Yeah, I'm a noob. I'm asking for help. And instead of getting help, I'm getting ridiculed for it. That's not the kind of community for gaming I would love to be involved in. I want to see our community as video gamers come together, become stronger, and fight against the real threat to our own community, to our own existence, to our hobby, to our livelihood. I want to see us come together. Stop fighting. And learn who the real enemy is. Because it's not each other. It's not the console fanboys. It's not the PC Master Race. It's not the Nintendies. Or the Nintendo Nerds. Whatever you want to call them. Or the PlayStation fuck cucks. Or the Xbox bitches. It's none of that. We need to come together. As a community. And face the real threat. And when all of you guys are ready to do that,